at cresd.org. We're so glad you're with us for today's Diane Rehm Show here on WAMU 88.5. Coming up at noon today, it's the Politics Hour. Conversations with Virginia's Governor Terry McAuliffe and D.C.'s Attorney General Carl Racine about everything from the future of politics in the Commonwealth to the state of juvenile justice in the district. That's all on the Politics Hour today from noon to 1 here on WAMU 88.5, streaming at kojoshow.org. Then later today, it's Science Friday. That's from 2 to 4, followed by All Things Considered this evening from 4 to 8. It's 10:06.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Diane Rehm. Donald Trump tweets that the U.S. should greatly expand its nuclear capability. President Obama announces a permanent ban on offshore drilling in parts of the Arctic. And North Carolina fails to repeal a controversial bathroom bill. Here for this very last Friday news roundup, Susan Page of USA Today, Manu Raju of CNN, and Abby Phillip of the Washington Post. And throughout the hour, we will be taking your calls, 800-433-8850. Send your email to drshow@wamu.org. Follow us on Facebook or send us a tweet. And welcome to you three.
Great to be here, Diane.
It's a privilege to be here on this last
Thank
day.
Thank you so much. Manu, the Electoral College cast their votes on Monday. Was it the landslide that Trump claimed it was?
Not quite. It was the 46th largest victory, Electoral College victory, out of 58 that this country has had. So not quite a landslide. In fact, the final number was 304 electoral votes for Donald Trump and 227 for Hillary Clinton. And what was interesting about this particular time was that there were this so-called faithless electors, people who did not vote the way that their state voted. And for Donald Trump, there were two people from Texas, electors from Texas, who did not vote for him. They voted for John Kasich and for Ron Paul instead. And for Hillary Clinton, there were five. Several from Washington State voted for Colin Powell. There was a vote for Bernie Sanders and vote for Faith Spotted Eagle getting an electoral vote. This is the largest, the most amount of so-called faithless electors in American history, larger than the 1808 race where James Madison lost
wow.
six electoral votes. So this is something that is really uncommon, obviously, and it's something that raises a lot of questions about the future of the Electoral College if we start to see a bunch of rogue electors voting however they want. It raises a lot of questions about what to do going forward.